So I've been watching some classic mystery shows due to looking for something comfortable to watch. You know, like Murder, She Wrote, Poirot, Sherlock Holmes in the 22nd century. But out of all of the mystery shows I've watched, there's been one show that's caught me red-handed. Columbo. Columbo is a detective show from the 70s that feels less like a cop show and more like a drifter solving murders and leaving to the next crime town. But something about this Ronin detective show really struck me. Every episode of Columbo just reminded me of the first case in Phoenix Wright Ace Attorney. I began to wonder if the show had more in common with my favorite game than just a schlubby guy. I love you, Dick. Columbo was created by Richard Levinson and William Link in 1971. It was very different from other mystery shows for one important reason. Instead of keeping the audience in the dark until the very end, the murder is revealed at the beginning of the episode. This inverted mystery concept dates back to the case of Oscar Brodsky by R. Austin Freeman in 1912, but it was still a pretty novel idea for a TV show in the 70s. Each episode of Columbo follows the same formula. In the first act, we witness the murderer commit
the perfect crime.
The killer is usually someone in power, like a politician, studio executive, or even a scientist. In the second act, Columbo enters and begins what William Link calls the duel. You know, the stuff we think police detectives do in real life. Alibi checking, pavement pounding, questioning witnesses. The third and final act is the pop, or the big breakthrough that allows Columbo to solve the case. This often involves Columbo catching the murderer in a contradiction and becoming so cornered that they can't help but confess to the crime.
And I thought I'd perform the perfect murder.
Perfect murder, sir.
Oh, I'm sorry, there is no such thing as a perfect murder. That's just an illusion.
Hold it!
The first turnabout is the first case in the Phoenix Wright series, and it uses the same inverted mystery style of storytelling. The player sees Frank Sawit committing murder by thinker. He believes he can pin his crime on Larry Butts, as he was the last person to meet with the victim. Sawit enters the trial as a witness. The trial of Mr. Butts continues as Phoenix Wright cross-examines Sawit's testimony and begins the duel. Phoenix Wright works through the testimony and uses contradictory evidence to prove that Frank Sawit was the murderer all along. Frank Sawit confesses to the crime and pop. The inverted mystery style works well for this case since it's effectively the tutorial. The goal isn't to figure out who did it, it's to gather enough evidence to be able to prove that they did it. Later in the game, the dynamic switches back to the classic whodunit style mystery. Still makes me wonder how Columbo and other mystery stories influenced a Japanese studio known for zombie and fighting games. For that, we would have to figure out how Sherlock Holmes ended up in Japan, and not the 22nd century. Detective stories have been around since we stopped accepting murder as something that just happens. So, of course, the late 1800s. Sherlock Holmes made his debut in 1887 and went to Japan a few years later with the translation of The Man with the Twisted Lip. After the turn of the century, Japan started translating the detective stories of Arthur Conan Doyle, G.K. Chesterton, and Edgar Allan Poe in short magazines. One of the first Japanese authors published in these magazines was Taro Hirai, also known by his pen name Edogawa Ranpo, who wrote The 2-Sen Copper Coin in 1923. Ranpo was at the forefront of Japanese mystery fiction and is considered the creator of the Hokaku mystery. A Hokaku mystery is a detective story that focuses mainly on the process of a criminal investigation and the fun that comes from trying to solve it yourself. Hokaku mystery usually include diagrams, floor plans, and maps that give readers all the info they need to solve the mystery. In the years following World War II, writers refined the form, moving it further away from the simple whodunits that Doyle had popularized. In the 70s, Japanese writers began translating episodes of hit American TV shows, such as Kojak, and, of course, our schlubby detective himself, in book form! Columbo hit Japanese TV in 1974, and its similarities to the Hokaku style made it an instant hit. Also, anime references kind of solidify that. One of his biggest fans was none other than Shu Takumi, the creator of Ace Attorney.
When I was a kid, I used to record the audio of Columbo episodes on cassette tape and listen to them in my room.
I did the same thing with Scooby-Doo episodes, but you don't see me making Scooby-Doo Hokaku out here. Anyways, back to Shoe.
There were 12 of us my year in the consumer division alone, and one by one, people got picked out for teams like Resident Evil and Breath of Fire. So half a year passed, and then a year. I stayed until the very last, watching over my seat in the training room.
Before entering the game industry, Takumi wanted to write mystery fiction, but was rejected by publishers. A friend from college told him about a game he was pitching, and Takumi decided to try. In 1994, he joined Capcom. The first game Takumi worked on was Scary Rumors at School, Hanako-san is here, in 1995. A game about a magical ghost girl doing stuff like this. After the game was released, Takumi moved over to Shinji Mikami's production studio 4. And after wrapping up a director's stint on Dino Crisis 2, Capcom decided to give Takumi free rein to do whatever he wanted with a small team and a small budget. So he got to work on, what else? A mystery game. Takumi is a Hokaku purist at heart who looked down upon most mystery games as passive experiences. One of the exceptions to that was Myst, which didn't have the appearance of a mystery story, but successfully captured the essence of one.
How can I change the passive reading experience of detective games into one where it truly feels like you solve the mystery yourself based on your own reasoning? From there, I arrived at the idea of pointing out contradictions in utterances of other people, and that was how I first arrived at the idea of an attorney.
Phoenix Wright was released in 2001 on the GBA in Japan. And while it performed okay there, sales in the US were pretty dismal. Despite that, Capcom greenlit more sequels and the series eventually gained momentum through word of mouth. Each game adds new elements to enhance the investigation and trial gameplay. But the central theme remains consistent through all six games in the series. It's what Takumi references as a puzzle plot mystery, where the focus is on logically and methodically solving a mystery. In his musings on mystery fiction, he brings up the idea that there are two roles, the great detective who figures out the truth, and the reader who is surprised by the truth. When a person watches an episode of Columbo, we're watching excellent detective work, but we don't get the satisfaction of being the reader. We're not surprised because we know the truth from the beginning by the nature of the show. Columbo is both the reader and the great detective. By contrast, in Phoenix Wright, the player takes on the role of the great detective and the reader. We're solving the case, and in doing so, we're surprised by the outcome. In Phoenix Wright, you're the Columbo of the courtroom, and the only thing you can't ask is one more thing.